Hello everyone, this is Meera Gupta and today in this video again I'm going to start class 10th English language and literature book First Flight, the very first poem Dust of Snow, composed by Robert Frost. In the previous video we have read the poem and understood the explanation, and here in this video I'm going to continue with the literary devices used in the poem. So, to know literary device, I'm going to read the poem for you all. Just listen it carefully. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had dreamed. First of all, you will learn here what is the rhyming scheme for this poem. So, the first line, the way a crow, ending word is crow, okay? Just mind it, crow, shook down on me. So, crow sounding word is different from the second ending word, me. Okay, so here you will start finding rhyming words by using a letter. Okay, so here put A for crow. Shook down on me. Me is different from crow, means sounding is not matching. So here you will write B. Dust of snow. Now just find out snow is matched with which word. So crow, snow, crow, snow. The sounding is matching with each other. So again you will write here in front of snow A. Okay. From a hemlock tree. Tree is matching with me. So here you will write B. The rhyming scheme for first stanza is A, B, A, B. Okay. Now look at the second stanza. Has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. Has given my heart. The word heart. Is it matched with the above words? No, it is not matching. So put here C. Okay. A change of mood. Is the word mood is matching with the other words? No. So write here D. Okay. C, D. The third line is and saved some part. Part. Part is matched with heart. Okay. So what will be here? C. Write here C. Of a day I had rued. Mood. Rued. It is matched with the mood. So again here D. So what is the rhyming scheme for the second stanza is C, D, C, D. Okay. So in this way you can just you can see that the rhyming scheme for this poem is A, B, C, D, C, D. Okay. Here I have written rhyming scheme is A, B, C, D, C, D. Now, next literary device is your alliteration. What do you mean by alliteration? The occurrence of the same letter or sound at the beginning of the adjunct of the closely connected words. Alliteration. Repetition of letter. Okay. Repetition of letter is known as alliteration. As example is given here. Has given my heart. Has. H. Heart. H. Okay. Here H letter is repeated. So, it is your alliteration. In the second line, sun saved some part. And saved some part. Saved. S, some S. So, repetition of S. So, again here, alliteration is used. Now, next literary device is inversion. Okay. Inversion. when the structure of a sentence is changed by the poet to create rhyme, this poetic license is called inversion. In stanza first, inversion can be seen. Okay, means when the sentence is changed by the poet to create rhyme, okay, that is your inversion. Now, second is assonance. What do you mean by assonance? A prominence of a vowel sound throughout a line is called assonance. Okay, the use of vowel sound in the line. Okay, such as example is given in stanza first, line 2. Sook down on me. Sook, double O. Double O is used. This is your O vowel sound. Down, O vowel sound. On, O vowel sound. So O sound is prominent here. So it is your assonance, figure up speech is used. Okay. Now, next is your enjambment. Enjambment means when the same sentence continues to the next line without the use of any punctuation mark. It is called enjambment. It has been used throughout the poem. Okay? Means when the same sentence continues the next line without the using of any punctuation mark. You can see in the poem. Here, the poem started, the way a crow swooped down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had viewed. Only at the end of the poem, full stop is used, okay? No any other punctuation is used, that's why it is your enjambment. So, these are the literary devices that used in the poem. I hope you understood it well. If there is any problem, you can drop a comment in comment box. Okay, and I also hope that you all should make notes on this poem also, and you should note down in your notebook too. Okay, now next question answer we will discuss in the next video class. Till then, goodbye, have a nice day.